good evening, and good evening. How are you guys? Kya haal hai, bakhair akhle, blah blah blah, stuff like that. Theek hai na, jo bhi hai. Shall I go in English or Urdu? Okay, let's put everything in English because there are a bunch of audience out there who comes at few and their native language is not Urdu. So that's one of the reasons. Okay, let's come to the topic. What I'm going to miss? If you are going for DA 780, what are you going to miss? Big question, right? Oh, I'm getting out of focus. I'm getting this. I'm getting Z6 dynamic range. I'm getting high ISO capability of Z6. High out of focus dynamic range, blah, blah, blah. Okay. So three things you will be getting in the 780. High out of focus, which I already shared a lot of hands-on videos. Okay. So you can, I want you to assure that whatever you are going to see over there, through the famous YouTube channels, how they are performing the eye autofocus and how I did. So I am more kind of a raw user, so whatever I shoot, I just share directly without going into post-processing and stuff. Okay, next. Okay, next. The Z6 high ISO and Z6 dynamic range, that will be there by default. Now the question is, what are we going to miss in DA780, right? What are we going to miss? Well, you will be missing a lot of things. Let me tell you how. First off, you will be missing the glass. Now you are going to say, how come, sir? How come, Babar bhai, how we are going to miss the glass? Well, you do, sir. You will be missing the glass. Well, how can I say that? Because that's in DSLR. So all the F-mount lenses, which Nikon is making since 1950s, they are all going to be used on that. That's true. But here is the thing. When Nikon launched the Z mount, Nikon basically, and Canon both, Canon released the RF EOS R mount and Nikon released the Z mount. So what basically these new mount made for the Nikon and Canon, that they opened up the new possibilities to make the better glass, which Nikon already released the RP lenses, so that's incredible lenses. And Canon released RP lenses, incredible lenses. Nikon released the Z lenses, which are incredibly sharp edge to edge. So basically, in Z mount, in mirrorless breed, you will be experiencing the best glass, like 24-70 2.8, right? That 24-70 2.8 lens is the best 24-70 2.8 out there from Nikon, and it's already been proven. I don't have to emphasize on that. You can go and check whatever the examples you. Even Tony Northup admits that Nikon Z mount 24-70 2.8 is the best. Okay, better than RP, better than Sony G Master, and blah blah blah. So Z mount is going to give you the best of the best of the best class, the lenses out there, which you won't be able to find in F mount. Well, how can I say that? Like 85 1.8 G, the sharpest 85mm out there from Nikon. Well, it was for only F mount, but when it comes to Z mount, 85 1.8 S has already beat the 85 1.8 G for the F mount. So Z mount glass is already providing superior quality, superior performance, color rendition, bokeh, stuff like that, acuteness, and all these characteristics which requires to measure a quality lens, that all be fine in Z mount. F mount lenses are good, very good. Nikon pushed all their expertise in order to develop the best of the best glass for the F mount for the DSLR breed, which you already experiencing. But there's a limit of everything. You need to understand that. Nikon was not able to meet f1.2 lenses on the F mount. Why? Because of the limitation of the mount size for the F mount. Now, using the Z mount, they are able to make 0.95 aperture lens, which is 58mm. Knocked. That's $8,000 lens, which is over a million Pakistani rupees. So, what do you expect? You cannot get everything in one plate. You cannot get the Z mount quality sharpness in the F mount lenses. No, you won't. If you want quality lens, if you want edge to edge sharpness, stuff like that, you have to switch to Z mount. There is no way. Let me give you another example. Nikon released 1424 2.8 lens in 2007. That's 13 years ago. Can you imagine? And it took Tamron and Sigma respectively 10 to 12 years respectively to reach to up to that level to make 1424 lens or equal to 1424 quality lens. But after 10 to 12 years, it took Tamron and Sigma that much time. Nikon released that quality in 2007. So when it comes to make the quality lenses, Nikon already have the upper hand. I'm not apple polishing or anything. I'm just sharing you the facts. It took 10 years by the other companies to reach to that optical level to make these kind of lenses like 1424 2.8, right? Now when it comes to Z mount, Nikon already released 1430 f4. I use that lens and I swear to God, I can sell. I really sell by 1424 2.8 in order to get 1430 f4. If anybody wants to buy 1424, please, because I'm not an astrophotographer, I don't need 2.8. For me, architecture, landscape, that matters. For that, I don't need 2.8 lens. I am very much okay with f4 because I will be shooting at f8 or f11 or something like that. So that lens is more than enough. And the best part of 14 to 30 f4 is it can take a filter, 82mm filter. In 1424, we always struggle to find a good filter to fit in the filter. So that's a trade-off. So Z mount provide the best optical quality with some features which you won't be getting in the F mount glasses. So when it comes to D780, you will be enjoying the high autofocus. You will be enjoying Z6 high ISO, Z6 superior dynamic range of Z6. You will be enjoying everything, but you will be using the F mount glass. So F mount glass is basically already you guys are using for 2470 G type, 85 1.4, 85 1.8, all G type. 105 F2DC, 180 F2.8 D-type, 200 to 500, 5.6. The best wildlife, the cheapest, best wildlife lens you can buy. 200 to 500, 5.6. You can imagine at 12 frames per second with D5 autofocus algorithm, you're going to use that 200 to 500 F5.6 lens. Imagine the output. I mean, I don't have to stress on you that you should already know that. If you are a Nikon shooter, you can quickly make the decision and go for it. So that D780 provide you the best of both world. You can enjoy the F mount glasses, but at the same time you will be missing what Z mount is going to offer you when it comes to lenses. So that's the whole idea of this video. You won't be able to have the Z mount quality lenses on D780. If you want that, you have to switch to Z6 and use the native lens. Don't use adapter. If you are going to use adapter, FTZ adopter, you will be missing a lot of shots, or you will be experiencing a slow autofocus. So if you are in event, fast pace event, you're catching sports, action, wildlife, the FTZ adopter is not a good idea. This is where D780, eye autofocus and all these features going to be, you know, help you. Imagine you are shooting and a sports guy, you are covering a cricket event, you are focusing on the bowler or a batsman or anybody, wicket keeper or fielder, who was running to get a catch, and you are sitting at the boundary line. So you have D780 and you have 200 to 500, 5.6. You need at least minimum 5.6 to get the best of high auto focus. So you are sure you are capturing the fielder who's ready to get the catch. So using the D780 high auto focus feature, you can capture that fielder while he going to dive and get the shot. This is just one example. Imagine the possibilities of using the D780 into sports action, wildlife, badminton, squash, soccer, especially the football game, Olympics are coming. So imagine. So this is what I am telling you. All the f-bond lenses will work flawlessly because they are going to be native lens. This is what I mentioned in my yesterday video when I launched, when I was on Facebook Live. As long as you are having native lenses, you are good to go. You don't have to worry about it. So imagine all of people who are having 400 2.8 or 600 f4 and you want to enjoy Z6 and stuff like that, or Z mount feature, and you are using FTZ adapter, of course you will be experiencing slow autofocus. But now with 780, you can get the best of both worlds. But at the same time, like I said earlier, for the Z mount glasses, you will not be enjoying that kind of quality lenses. For me, Z mount, I mentioned this thing several times, Z mount, it's all about glass. It's not about mirrorless. You probably think it's a mirrorless. No. Just for example, look at the eye autofocus feature. You thought that it was only for the mirrorless, right? But look, now it's in the DSLR. See? Z mount is not about mirrorless. I said this before and I just prove it to you. Z mount is not about mirrorless. It's about quality glass. The eye autofocus and all those things, the EVF, forget about the EVF. Everybody was crying eye autofocus, right? Sony eye autofocus, Sony eye autofocus. Now you have in the DSLR. Go ahead and explore. You thought, okay, Nikon and Canon released the mirrorless for the eye autofocus because it was only for the eye autofocus. No, it is not. Now Canon also released the eye autofocus in 1DX Mark III. Same thing Nikon did for D780, and I'm pretty much sure 99% that it will be there in the D6 and the next upcoming D880. So that eye autofocus was not a big deal at all. The only thing that was a big deal was making a quality lenses, which was not possible for Nikon and Canon because of the shorter mount for the both the US mount and the F mount. Now they have USR and the Z mount. Now they are making the lenses. Look at Canon 28-70 f2. Was that possible in the US mount? No, it was not possible. They only made it for the USR mount. Look at Nikon. Nikon only made one f1.2 lens, which is 50mm and 58mm also, 55mm 1.2 and 58mm 1.2. So now I can make only 3 lenses in 1.2. They haven't made 4 their native lens for 85mm. Canon did, because their mount was a little bigger than f-mount. Because Nikon and Canon both suffering from the shorter mount. Now with this new mirrorless mount, they are opening up the possibility. So the mirrorless for Nikon and Canon, it's all about the lenses, not about the eye out of focus, not about the mirrorless thingy. No, I just prove it to you. So the good thing for D780, you will be enjoying your existing glass with eye out of focus. See, native lens. I shot today, I swear to God, and I was like, damn. When I was shooting D780 today, I put 70-200 2.8 EFL lens. Oh my God, that lens is bloody sharp. That lens is bloody sharp. So I was shooting, imagine you have 85 1.8 G type lens, you have 105mm f2 DC lens, 135mm f2 DC lens, Tamron 35mm 1.4 lens, a new one, 58mm f1.4 G type lens, 200-500 f5.6 E type lens. All these lens, you put it on D780 and you will enjoy, I can assure you. Assalamu alaikum Ghazi bhai. Yes Ghazi bhai, I am trying to, you know, give the technical details, so whoever out there who is technically enough to understand all these things can go with that. I am very much open to reply for any question regarding to D780, because D780 is providing the best of both worlds, DSLR and mirrorless. For the mirrorless, if you want quality glass, you will have to go for mirrorless. If you have already the lenses and you are satisfied from it, go for D780 straight away, bar none. You will be enjoying eye out of focus. You will be having 2 card slots. You will be having longer battery life. What else you need? So I'm, even you can use for bird action wildlife at 12 frames per second and live. And I'm going to do it over the next coming weekend. I'm already chasing Nikon Middle East to give me the camera for a test run, and I will be pushing that camera to its limit for sure. It will be fun. The next weekend will be fun. The only thing I care about is the sensor output, which I'm already assuming is going to be Z6. Let's see. So hopefully you got my point, that if you want quality lenses, you have to go with Z mount. If you already enjoying your F mount glass, then, and you want high auto focus thing, you have to go with D780. You cannot have everything in one plate. It never happened, it won't happen. Neither from Nikon, nor from Canon, for sure. And by the way, yeah, one more thing. People were telling me, oh, what if D780 also going to have a bug like D750? I have 2 things to say on that. First off, it won't going to have any bug because its chassis is different. Its chassis is D850 chassis. The D750 chassis was D610, which already having an issue. So so for your D780 won't be suffering any kind of issue or any kind of recall. It's not like Sony, oh we have bug, no problem, we'll release a new model. Not like Sony. If Sony ever having any bug in their camera system, they're releasing a whole new body. They're not recalling like Nikon. I think as I said enough. Thank you. Bye.